Oh, hi, I'm Mayor Ken Moore. Welcome to this year's State of the City. And this year we have a really fun theme, Making Municipal Magic. Today we'd like to start out with some of our amazing accomplishments this year. Our staff certainly makes it seem like magic, but we all know a lot of hard work goes into making a city run and our residents happy with city services. Well, instead of just talking about it, why don't I just show you? Looks like I'm a little overdressed. Oh, that's better. The Parks Department, along with the help of the community, completed 3 new canoe launches, making a total of 7 within the city with several stops along the Harpeth River. Here's a map located on our website if you'd like to get out and enjoy the river this spring and summer. Our canoe launches are not the only park's accomplishments. They've also completed the 3rd Avenue North Trail project along the Harpeth River from Point Park connecting to Bicentennial Park. Over at Harlandsdale, a multi-use equestrian arena was completed in partnerships with Friends of Franklin Parks. We also moved and enlarged the Canine Dog Park, which is a popular place for our 4-legged friends. And we all know dogs need water, and so do people. And as you can see here at the water treatment plant, we were in need of an upgrade, and staff started this process last year. The project includes a new building to house upgraded technology and equipment. Some original equipment to this plant was more than 50 years old. The upgrade cost approximately $14 million. This facility is scheduled to be complete by the end of 2017. We always have safety in mind, be it water or the next place where we're going where we don't even need a magic wand. This is Fire Station 8 in West Haven, which opened last year.
This $3.8 million station is 11,369 square feet, featuring 3 apparatus bays, living and sleeping quarters, and a kitchen and eating area. Opening this station and another soon in Ladd Park will help us keep the top ISO rating, which means your insurance rates remain low. Our police department also works tirelessly to deliver the highest quality public safety services to our community, and was once again recognized with the highest ranking by CALEA, which is the gold standard in professional excellence. We've been recognized by this agency every year since 2001, and under the direction of Chief Deb Faulkner, the department continues community outreach to maintain and grow relationships with the people they serve.
Hey, Mayor, do you need a ride?
No, where we're going, we don't need roads.
Huh?
Last year, we took a healthy step toward making Franklin more walkable through a program called Invest Franklin. This is putting your tax dollars to work for you.
This sidewalk is part of our Sidewalk Gap project. So far, we have completed 5,000 linear feet of connecting sidewalks that before never went anywhere. This one happens to go to our new Columbia State campus, something I am personally proud of and will help generations to come in furthering their education right here in their own backyard. This campus can accommodate 2,200 students studying sciences, arts, and humanities, and more. It features state-of-the-art labs and study spaces.
From study hall to city hall, we've accomplished a lot inside these walls. I'm underdressed. This is an improvement. This is our Building and Neighborhood Services Department, where our online inspection process has greatly improved.
About 78% of the applications this department received in 2016 were approved within the 35-day review cycle, which means projects get to market sooner. The amount of activity the development services team saw last year is quite amazing. $750 million, which is $250 million more than the previous year. Building and Neighborhood Services continues to improve all processes for citizens and contractors.
As long as our customers keep their ducks in a row.
Now this really seems to comply with their master plan. Jonathan,
this is our engineering department. They completed an important study after 3 years they call the Comprehensive Transportation Plan.
The plan outlines transportation strategies and projects for the city to implement based on the city's long-range land use plan. With a lot of input from the community, the result is a detailed transportation master plan making operational improvements, creating a community-wide bicycle and pedestrian network, and increasing connectivity as we grow and expand into the future.
Honk if you like progress. Over in the planning department, staff likes to call the long-range plan for the city Envision Franklin.
This two-year process concluded in 2016. The planning team designed this plan along with our hundreds of citizens who provided feedback. Envision Franklin provides the long-term vision that will direct future development in a way that strengthens the city and creates exceptional places for people.
This is truly the key to Franklin's future.
Look! Where did you get that?
I don't know, it just was here.